In the middle.
Of course you have shorts and that. What are you doing?
What? I'm hydrating. Good morning.
What do you think about waking up to this?
I'm excited. I'm actually kind of like a snow pony. I'm from Colorado, so this is okay.
Till I can't no more. I got the horses in the back.
Me and one of my very, very close friends, we just started out on doing this gravel thing in like 2016. We called ourselves the gravel ponies on the team. So then we thought it would be a good idea to get matching tattoos of ponies. And now we're permanently the gravel ponies for life.
Let's go do a little recon of course and see what we got.
I mean, honestly, I'm like having flashbacks to my career. Like we used to do this race in the springtime. It's actually going on right now, Paris-Nice. And like a day or two like this was like part of the race, right? And so like I'm just getting flashbacks of like, you know, looking out the hotel room and then seeing this and then, you know, driving to the start, just wondering, you know, what's gonna happen, what it's gonna feel like. Know that it's ice cold, feet will be cold, hands will be cold, bike is gonna be trashed. And so I guess like we are right now going to look at it because I think as a rider, I would have wanted to know what to expect. Even though we don't have the race till tomorrow, we've got time for the conditions to improve. But we are going to pre-ride it here in a little bit. And so just want to see what the riders are going to expect this afternoon. And so we can prepare the bikes and clothing and get the warm up down. Part of me wants to just have them ride trainers, but I don't know how possible that is. They would have to start now.
I'll get out of it, but can you just try the bars real quick? How does that feel, that change?
Feels good. I'm doing race openers in a hotel room at the Holiday Inn because they're racing Mid-South tomorrow and it's a little bit snowy outside. Saving the bike. I don't want to ruin the bike today. So, the hotel room. I'm inside a hotel room right now, guys. Did a lot of shit, just live this here lifestyle. Came straight from the bottom to the top of my lifestyle.
Heading to Packet Pickup for Mid-South Gravel Race, and run is finishing right now, the 50K. It's happening. It's awesome.
Are you getting one, Travis?
No, I was trying to put it back. I shouldn't have looked.
Coffee always comes first before check-in. So once we get the coffee, then we can work on check-in, but coffee's always first, no question.
You like coffee?
I had a coffee or two.
Yeah, hell yeah.
And my drip coffee.
About to go test the course with our test riders, Coach Travis here, and then our mechanic, who's a good racer himself, Joe. We're gonna go see how the tires ride, and what the what the conditions feel like for the bike riders. We're testing the Rene Hirst Snoqualmie Pass 44, which is a slick tire, but it has a big size to it, so it should handle quite good in the ice, mud, and then it's super fast, like if it's on some pavement or if it's on some hard packed gravel. It's actually really fast in the loose stuff as well. So we're gonna make sure it's rideable. These guys are able to do it. And so we had our riders ride the trainer today so they didn't spend any energy out in the cold. We're gonna have these guys do it for them. And then we will, with your help, record it and then report back to them this afternoon with our final choice on what to expect for tomorrow.
Perfect.
Yeah, like, even in that corner, I saw it was gripping better.
No chance of anything but slicks.
You really gotta put that effort in and go and look, because you know there are just some details. Like now, we can go back and tell the team, guys, it's good. You know, this is what it looks like. They can visualize and mentally get ready. Whereas, you know, maybe if you've seen some of the pictures on the internet that's going around, how bad it is, how muddy it is, how snowy it is. Mentally, you can get a little, you can be maybe a little bit checked out and stuff for that. So good to see that. And yeah, I'm confident in our equipment choice. Lance here wants only you to get her food, not you to get the other's food. Are they asking you for food? Because I'm asking you for food, and if someone else,
is asking you for food, that's not
I
okay.
Am Lance and Holly. Everyone. Only takes care of me.
At the road race? Oh yeah, he's good. Yeah,
he's
good
gonna too. Go fucking fast, cause he's like you got. He's a climber.
Once you get to mile 92, you will be at the Shots at the Cemetery, brought to you by John Vargas, owner of Orange Seal.
Yeah, just put your bike where our bikes are.
Yeah.
Like Travis,
should we scoot the aero bars out just a little bit, cause they are more narrow?
Yeah. Yeah, I mean you have your bars taped all the way in. I would.
Maybe not like that. Maybe just rotate them up. I might not even need them out more.
Yeah.
So.
Can you check her seat and stuff? Like, when it feels
I don't know
if it just moves a little bit or what?
Feels pretty sick.
What's the strategy called?
Convenience.
I'm gonna look for a fork too.
I have a used fork.
What'd you get?
Okay.
Oh, I was just saying, as Travis, the performance.
You got offended by that.
Oh, really?
Yeah.
Oh, shit. Sorry.
Can you tell?
I'm sorry, Travis. Didn't mean to offend you. We have to cut.
redo.
Oh, cut. I just was proud of my eggs. Like, I'm not good at a lot of things.
You're right. You crushed it, and mine looks like shit.
Well,
call a spade a spade.
Look,
it's fine. Yours is amazing. Mine looks like shit. You're
in,
right.
In my defense, like you've been in Norway for a long time, and they don't have the hot skillet oven there.
Seems like it's good, right?
Mm-hmm. Because the friction that you're hearing isn't the wheel; it's the oil.
Okay.
But I have a special oil for this. But this just came out of the shower, and I was like really getting in there.
Sick.
Athletes need carbohydrates. Carbohydrates was like the gas in the tank. So no gas in the tank, can't go. So another big thing is hydration. So if you can kill two birds with one stone, let's do that. So lots of rice. And yeah, so you carry the rice cooker everywhere and make your magic happen.
Kind of feels weird to do like the slurping on the spoon too.
I was
like
really bad at that. Yeah.
Well, it's like completely like against
etiquette.
Any kind of manners at all.
You guys have done the training, you guys have done the work. Everyone here is at a really good level. Like, all we want to see from you guys tomorrow is to just go hard, okay? And I don't even want to get crazy with strategy or tactics or anything like that. I just want you guys to execute some good, hard, fast bike riding. That's it. Just a big training ride, okay? Next thing I want you guys to work on tomorrow is I want you guys to own every part of the experience, right? So if you're nervous right now, own that and say, I feel nervous and this is why. I've worked hard, I'm really excited, I want to prove myself or whatever. Look at that nervousness, look at that, take that ownership in it, right? And take a step back and look at yourself, right? From outside your body and say, does that make sense, right? Is that feeling in line with how things are going for me? Is that really necessary? Do I need that? You know, take that ownership in the good and the bad. Don't think of the reasons why you can't do something. Think of the reasons why you can, right? All of the reasons why you can succeed tomorrow in, right, riding freaking hard and doing a badass ride. That's it. I think, like, zone wise, right, like when you're on your own in the beginning, you've got to stay with the group. So you've got to, and Cinch people that are out there listening, right, like you got to stay with the riders that you're with, you know, and as long as you can. And then when you get gapped off or you go ahead, then you ride your zones. And so the zones of choice for tomorrow are ideally low threshold on the climbs, high threshold or nuclear over the top to build the speed, and then medium after that, and low medium. And then of course, if you're able to cruise once you get up to speed even less, that's fine, okay? But like, let's not be under some grand illusion that we'll be able to do the whole race at low threshold or something like that tomorrow. We walked or saw some of the two critical points at mile 24. There's a mud pit, something like out of that, what is the Spartan races or whatever. It's like out of the Spartan races. So like, no chance. You have to participate in this obstacle just like you would in the Spartan race. So get off your bike, put your bike on, as Joe says, suitcase, carry it. Keep it out of the mud, because remember, you're on that bike for a long time. So if you drop that bike in the mud, you're gonna have mud for no reason at all. So suitcase, carry it, take your time through the section, check out, get back on your bike, and get back to work. We're just here to practice. I'm here to practice. Travis is here to practice. Joe's here to practice. It's not about like matching the zones up perfectly. It's about playing the game, trusting your zones, trusting the fitness. And then once it all settles out in whatever scenario is created, you maximize what you've got at the end.
Ready.
Hey, does this look good?
Do it again. That was so amateur. Like, nobody comes in like that.
Does this look good?
Oh my gosh, it looks so good. Look at this. Look at this. Look at this. Oh, it's just so arrow. This is like touching here and the wind's just gonna go.
I'm ready.
Oh, that's so suicidal. That's insane. There's no one that's touching her. Tomorrow will be an early morning. Probably get up at 5, and I want to be out the door at 6 o'clock with the bikes. We're gonna get the van. We have a camper van, so we'll get that out there early, warmed up, and so the riders will have that to relax in and stay warm at the start line. And I'm gonna try to park it. There'll be a lot of traffic there, so I'm gonna try to park it close to the start so they can stay in it into the last minute. And then we have an exciting day. Troy, who's holding the camera right now, and I are gonna get out on, not on course, but dive into different sections of the course to video it and try to capture how the race unfolds. And then we'll have Travis, Joe, and Joe in the pit. There's one pit and they can be there. So they'll be there with spare wheels, spare bike equipment, nutrition, chain lube, ways to clean stuff, like if it gets muddy out there. And so, yeah, it should be action-packed tomorrow. Really excited to see how it goes down.
Heck yeah.
My favorite thing to do on a Saturday.
Exercise vacation is the only type of vacation we like to go on.
It's just like kind of full, but doing it.
How you doing?
I'm I'm doing good. Doing good. Early wake up, not too early, but yeah, it'll be good.
Tell me about what's going through your head. How's your body feeling?
Just trying to be relaxed. Gonna go eat some cereal, load up, get as full as I can, because it's a long race, 5 hours. So, gotta be as full as possible. You know, throw up maybe if I eat too much, but as long as I'm full, I'll be good.
You gotta earn the good spot though, right? Like, you gotta get here at 6 to get the good spot, although no one else knows where the good spot is, so. Huh?
He said there's no bikes on the start yet, or there's nobody rolled up yet. And I said, somebody gotta start this.
Just need it to win.
You're gonna start it?
Fuck, there's some bikes out there. Let's get it going.
Dude, bikes are good. Got all of them in the shower last night. So they're all clean. Everything's been soaking with chain lube. Last thing to do really is just check tire pressures. Everything has been run through so many times, exhaustively so they're ready to go. All the batteries are charged. Yeah, they're looking good.
Sun's out, gun's out. Everyone's ready. It's pretty cold out here though, like 20 degrees. So, feels like Pyrenees. But yeah, couldn't ask for a better day, and see how it goes.
Let me down easy, for your love for me is gone. Let me down easy, since you feel to stay here alone. I know it's all over, but the last goodbye.
Starting to split up a little bit, but you know, I think positioning is important for Lauren, and I hope she can start to get that a little more dialed going into these next sections. It should split all apart with that running part, so we'll see what happens there. And all the guys are in the front, which is good to see that. Everyone looks good.
Yeah, two girls ahead of you, they're just ahead of you. Come on, come on!
Yeah,
need right now. Those gaps, I think right now it's open and windy, so unfortunately I think those gaps will probably go up. It's difficult now because Lauren's in a group that's probably moving slower than the group of the leaders. So we'll see what ends up happening. But definitely in a difficult spot right now. Her race. Holly's behind her. We don't know how much behind, but we'll see soon. Yeah, crazy. Crazy opening to the race as usual. Good job, guys. Good job. Good job, Matt. We have 2 minutes.
Yeah, Lord.
2 minutes to Sylvia. 2 minutes. Clear, guys. Clear. Good job. 1 minute to Ruth.
Yeah, Holly.
Just ahead of you. Come on. Come on. Come on. About 30 seconds, 30 seconds. Good job, Matt, good job. Bridge the gap to the leader 2 minutes in the last 10 miles.
Let's go.
Yeah, Lauren.
Yeah, Lauren, let's go. Woohoo!
That's insane. She's incredible. I don't know how she does it. She's absolutely, she's catching the guys. Like
when that split happens, like, you know, the faster riders are generally together and the weaker riders are generally behind. And in that case, she was with a group that was not as strong as the group that Sylvia was in. And so that's why, you know, in that moment I said, we gotta go. Like, you gotta bridge this gap. And in my mind, I'm thinking, and I'll be honest, right? Like, there's no way I could have done that. You know what I mean? Like, no way. Wow. Don't know how she did it. And, I mean, I know she's very strong and very mentally strong. But I wouldn't want to race against Lauren, that's for sure. Like, I think she's, when she's on.
I was a little bit too far back right there, like, and I'm not great at running through the mud, I guess, and all the things. It was a running part, so yeah. So I was a little bit far back, and I just continuously closed. I was with Ruth and Mariah for a while in like a little group, but then at the time, I was like, we got to a little climb, maybe around mile 60 after the creek, and I was like, all right. Now's my time.
Eric, so, Stillwater, Oklahoma. You got to Eric. Good job.
You chased in Sevilla, and then you guys rode together for a bit. And at what point did you decide to ride away from her?
I was the only one pulling. Okay. So I knew that I just had to like get a gap, and I was going to be able to ride away.
Look out.
In the running section, I was a few back, and then I couldn't clip into my pedal right away. And I was like trying to clip in, and then there's just a huge gap, and I chased really hard, and then I just exploded at like 3 hours in, and found a group of six guys and rode with them to the finish. Yeah, it was so fun.
Get out of my shoe!
So ready,
you want these fingers to miss out?
Yeah. Yeah, Holly.
I care about the finisher.
Holy shit, Holly.
Here comes Danny from that town. We don't talk about the town up here. But that matters, Holly. We got Jamie, Christopher, Timothy, John.
He was killer.
Yeah. Dude, Burger was blowing
my mind. He was climbing it up.
Dude,
so good.
I was like,
let's go.
Remember when I was like,
Troy captured the whole thing, like all the meltdowns, all the like frustrations. Like a couple times, he's like, "Hey Tom, can I get a clip or something?" He's like, "No, no, it's all going to shit right now."
This place, there's no way God's be nerd. He's gonna miss.
Huge round of applause for our women's champions.
Alex from Stillwater. And here from Oklahoma City, Oklahoma.
Go for it.
Rick, Ricky Morty, 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 Ricky Mor